Hey, what is up, guys? Brandon here, and welcome back to another episode of the Minecraft Pocket Edition Realms SMP, the Realms Survival Multiplayer. And today, guys, we're back with episode 5, and we have a lot planned for this episode. But just before that, I have a lot that I actually want to talk about that happened off-camera, things like that. First off, I do want to apologize. It has been about a week since I've uploaded, and I know that's actually kind of good considering my reputation for not uploading and just kind of vanishing, but I do want to apologize. I've just been super actually distracted lately, where the new Pokemon Go app came out and I started playing that, and I had my job that was finishing up. It was the last week of my job, and it worked out actually pretty funny because my job was in the middle of the city, and so there were so many Pokestops and Pokemon that it's been 3 days. I'm like level 10 and I have over 100 Pokemon, and I've visited over 100 Pokestops. So I've been tweaking nonstop of that game, and it's ridiculous. But yeah, let me know in the comments if you guys want me to see me record that, because I might do that. I'm considering it. I'm not too certain, and I don't really know if you guys would want to see that anyways. So I mean, definitely let me know. In addition to that, you know, as always, I've been playing League and getting distracted by that. League of Legends, if any of you guys have played it, you're amazing, because I don't know why I play that game. It makes me so frustrated, but it's so fun. And also, I've been in class. I'm taking summer school, but this coming week is my last week of class, so that'll be great. But sadly, the week after that, I'm actually going on a trip. So there will be approximately 2 weeks of little to, actually probably not even little, there'll probably be zero uploads for that 2 week span, because I am going to California for college tours. I'm visiting 6 colleges, I believe. So if any of you guys are in the California area, definitely let me know. You know, maybe we can meet up or something, I don't know. And then after that, I'm going back to school. So rip my summer, it's not gonna be fun. Well, it is gonna be fun, just I'm not gonna be able to record. But anyways, so off camera, we've actually done a lot. We went mining, and so in this chest, we have what we found. And there was this huge cave, guys. It's ridiculous. I'll point it out on the way to where we're going in this episode. But if we look into this chest, this is what we've got. So we visited the Nether briefly, so we got some Nether quartz. So I'm just gonna grab all of this. And then we actually have 15 diamonds. So I'll have the screenshots on screen right now. I found 3 different veins. I think it was 8, 7, and 2. So I did get these legit, and I was in a call with Harrison Fusion when it happened, and Rage. And Rage was kind of, he was raging. Get it, the puns. Sorry for that pun. But yeah, Rage was raging because I was mining in his cave, and you know, his cave, his diamonds. So I might have to give them to him. I'm not gonna give it to him. Don't tell him I said that though. And I also found a lot of redstone, some lapis, and some coal. So yeah, I'm just gonna put this into my inventory, and we don't have our fortune pick on us. But yeah, also we found this bunch of iron, things like that, so we're going to smelt that later. Actually, I'll just toss some in right now. I'll just get a stack of iron for each one. And then yeah, so today, guys, we are going to be doing the house tours. Now, this was something that you guys I suggested it, and you guys were extremely positive on the feedback, and that you guys wanted me to tour everyone's houses. So that is what I'm gonna be doing this episode, because you know, episode 5 seems like a good little I guess a little landmark or milestone, not a landmark, a milestone, that you know, we made it to 5 episodes. I mean, hell, on my channel, I have very few series that make it to 5 episodes, and that's actually kind of sad. But anyways, so today we're going to be touring everyone's houses. But yeah, off camera, once again, everyone has been dying a lot, myself included. I died once, but it wasn't my fault. I died due to a glitch, which I will show you guys later on in this episode. But yeah, people have just been dying left and right. It's been hilarious. But yeah, I'm going to go grab my fortune pick and grab what I want to enchant for this episode. As always, you got to keep that tradition up, and I will see you guys right back here. Alrighty, so we are back, and I grabbed my fortune pickaxe over here, and if you guys notice, we actually upgraded from last time. This is now a diamond pickaxe. Last time was just a fortune 3 pickaxe, you know, iron, and only fortune 3, but now we have a fortune 3, unbreaking 3, and efficiency 4 on it. So that is actually really, really nice, guys. So yeah, I was just enchanting things like that, and I was able to find the right combination of books and whatnot, so pretty lucky there off camera. But yeah, we have all of the ores in our hands right now, so we are just going to start with, I guess we'll just start with the quartz. And I'm going to be mining these, so there are 18, so we're going to see how many we can get. And seeing as this is efficiency 4, this should just mine right through it, because I don't know why, quartz is surprisingly easy to break. Like, oh my gosh, look at this. Like, netherrack as well is just extremely easy to break through. Just like anything in the nether, really, you shouldn't have any trouble breaking through. So we got 37 quartz from that, over double. So that is actually really, really nice. Next, I think I'm going to save the diamonds for last. So we're going to go through the lapis, just see how much we can get. Oh boy. Okay, we're going to have to stack this up, aren't we? Okay, so this is going to take some creativity here because... Oh gosh, how are we going to mine all the redstone actually though? Because we have like well over a stack of this. Oh my gosh. Holy lapis. We had 25, I believe. How much are we going to... Oh. Oh, this shouldn't be legal. This shouldn't be legal. No, where is the... 5.5 stacks. Oh my gosh, that shouldn't be legal. What is Fortune 3? 2 redstone and I have 12. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm gonna just go through this. Oh, even more. We missed some. Okay, I'm just gonna go through like a little bit of this coal because we are actually running a little bit low. But other than that, did I just put a block into myself and hurt myself? That is actually really dumb. Okay, so let's just mine through all this coal, see how much we get. I used, what, I had 41, so 41 to 12, 8, 21, 29, 29 coal, I believe. Let's just use all 41, why not? Yeah, we're just gonna use all 41. I think that's how much I had. Who's gonna mine through all of this and a stack and 41? Oh my gosh, okay, here's the moment you guys have all been waiting for, guys. I just said guys twice in the same sentence. Oh gosh, I'm so excited for this. The diamond ore. Watch a creeper just walks up and blows up. Oh, I would be so mad. Okay, see how much we get. From that one, it's just one. We got 3 from that one, just one. I'm not gonna pick them up until I get all of them. And let's just mine through all of this. Ooh, that is a lot more than 15. We got 1, 4, 9, 10, 15, 17, 18, 27. Wow. Okay, we got 27 diamonds. We are really rich. Okay, guys, I have a quick challenge for you guys. I'm going to speed up real quick and place down all this 64 redstone. I want and then mine it, and I want you guys to guess how much redstone we are going to get from this. Just pause the video, comment down below how much you think we're going to get, and yeah, let's see who can be the closest. I'm going to guess what we got. I'm going to guess that we're not going to have enough room in our inventory for this redstone. I'm going to guess like 8 stacks. That's going to be 8.5 going on almost 9 stacks. That's going to be my guess. So I'm just going to build all of this up, and I will see you guys once I start breaking it. Oh my goodness, guys, look at all this redstone. Oh my gosh, maybe 8 stacks wasn't enough, but I was definitely right in that I will not have enough inventory space to hold all of this. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh, Fortune 3 is just... No. Oh my gosh. Do I even have enough space now? Oh, I do. Oh, wait. Do I have enough space? Can I hold it all? Can I? It's gonna be close. These final 2. Oh, hey, I can't hold it all. Okay, how much was that? Oh, wow, okay. That was not as much as I thought it was gonna be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 and 8. So I was about 2 stacks off, which... That's weird, because, like, lapis... We got only a stack more, but it was 25 lapis compared to a stack of redstone. That's weird. Huh. Anyways, maybe lapis just has a habit of, you know, giving you more. I don't know. But anyways, we are just going to go drop all of this off. I do believe I actually had a extra diamond in one of the chests. I cannot move. But yeah, so I was actually originally planning on enchanting an iron axe. But since we have so many diamonds, yeah, okay, I do have a diamond in this chest. And we have so much lapis. Oh gosh. Okay. Let me just dump all this stuff in here. Wow, I'm gonna have to transfer this to my secret chest afterwards. And yes, guys, I will eventually show you my secret chest, but that will be once I'm moving, so that, you know, it kind of defeats the point of having the secret chest anymore. So, yeah. You guys will never figure out my secret chest. Unless one of you guesses it. If one of you guys does guess it in the comments, I will be fair and I will tell you whether you got it right or not. But, yeah, we're just gonna plop all this stuff in here. Grab 1, 2, 3 diamonds, 1, 2, 3 lapis. Then grab my 2 sticks from right over there. We're gonna make this diamond axe. Let's see how our smelting's going. We got 35, so 71 iron. Nice. Oh, and I also kind of stole this sword from Eris. It has looting 3 on it, so we might use that later on. I'm not too sure. But I'm just going to place the rest of this, what we didn't use, in here. And actually, if I'm going to, for the, what is it, the tradition that we're going to be doing, I'm actually going to enchant a book while we're there, because why not? And also, apparently, someone commented on my last video pointing out that there is a glitch in the enchantments, which I had mentioned, and that the glitch is only for MCPE, or on a device, but the Windows 10 version works. But apparently I was talking to Eris and the books actually don't glitch, so I'm not too sure about that, but we're just gonna test it here. So we're gonna put the axe in. The 1, 2, 3. Let's see if we can get something good. That's not what I wanted. It's really, why is there smite on an axe? Why? Oh, that is so not what I wanted. I wanted like an efficiency axe, not a sharpness. Damn it. That is not what I wanted. Oh, that is pretty funny though. Okay, let's see what we're gonna get on the book. Protection. Okay, no, the book is definitely glitched because I know for a fact that I have a Prot 3 Silk Touch 1 book. So we're just gonna plop it into the community chest because I swear there is a Prot 3 Soak Touch 1 book, unless I stole it. Oh, there's a Fortune 3 book in there. Wow, these enchantments. I'm gonna have to steal some of these sometime. I think it is glitched for me. No, okay. It was back in my house. Oh, wait, did I? I put the wrong one back, didn't I? Where'd it go? Where'd my, what? Wait, what? There we go, that's mine. Soak Touch 1 and Protection 3. So we're just gonna go back to our chest room. Get all prepped up. I'll see you guys in the morning when this turns to daytime, and then I will start the tour. I'm sorry that this introduction is taking a little long, but I mean, hey, we got 27 diamonds, so I mean, well, we wasted 3 of them on this axe, so I'm just gonna sadly put this back in here, and yeah, I will see you guys when we are ready to start the tours. Alrighty guys, so I'm back really quick just to point out, I thought I saw this book before. It was because it is glitched. I have the exact same book here, Protection 3, Soak Touch 1. I enchanted it before I had one in my chest, so it does look like the enchantments are glitched for the books too. I don't know. Apparently, well, Eris does play on Windows 10, so that might be why it's not glitched for him. Not too sure, but this is a bummer, so if it is glitched, I will discontinue the book enchanting tradition, because I don't really want to get Silk Touch 1 and Prot 3 every time. So I do apologize if that turns out to be the case, but yeah, we'll see how it goes from here. Anyway, we're just gonna put our potatoes in here. We're gonna grab some food because we're gonna be doing a lot of walking this episode, and let's get started with the tours. Oh wait, I need to put stone in this slot and then food. There we go. Alrighty, so first off, the first stop is, of course, my little humble home, which is actually a temporary home, guys. So this is just somewhere where I am staying. And for those of you who haven't really figured it out yet, this is actually directly underneath Eris's house, which is the next stop that we are going to be going to. So right over here, we have Eris's house. It takes up this entire mountainside, and he is currently working on the farms. He has a nice little bridge going across with some sugarcane over there. So if we go up here, there is 3 or 4 rooms, I believe. So you come in here, and this is just his main room. This is where usually his dogs are, as well as 2 farms that I helped him set up, carrots and potatoes. As well as a melon farm, and then he has the animal farm back here, which, for some reason, all of them keep vanishing. Like, he had a sheep farm, which I colored all the sheep, if you remember from episode 1. They vanished. Last episode, he had a bunch of cows, a bunch of pigs, like 3 horses. They're gone. I don't know what's wrong. But if you go down here, he has a secondary path leading to this mountain that actually used to be a cave, believe it or not. But yeah, the cave went kaboom. But anyways, if we go back over here, I don't know where that's leading, actually. That's brand new. Yeah, he didn't tell me everything. Also, if you tell by these steps, he actually didn't mean to do that to him in his texture pack. This wood all looks the same, so Yeah, also he's colorblind, so that might be why. But yeah, so I thought it was just pretty funny that happened. Over here is his main room with all his chests. You know, he has his nice little chest with all of his enchanted stuff, which I would love to steal, but you know, I'm a nice person. As well as if you go over here, we have this cobblestone wall. Over here is nothing too great, just another entrance, but down here is where the magic happens. Just kidding, nothing really happens. Here we have some potions, which I'm going to be working with in a future episode. And then down here we have some nether warts, which aren't growing for some reason. But yeah, also, Eris not only has one guest, but he has two guests. So beside myself, someone else is actually staying at his house, and that would be Sammy. So you guys probably don't know Sammy. She sometimes shows up in Eris's videos, but she's a really, really close friend of mine and Eris's, and basically the whole group that we have with Rage and Fusion. So she doesn't do YouTube or anything like that, but if you want to go and follow her, find out who she is, etc., I'll have her links for her Twitter and Instagram in the description below just for this episode. So if you want to figure out who she is, you can check out her Twitter, her Instagram. Definitely hit her up with a follow. She's a really nice person. So yeah, she joined us because... Oh, no, 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 no! Oh my god. I swear, every episode, it's this goddamn nether portal. It's this damn nether portal. Why? Just why? Oh my god, that is... Oh, that is hilarious. Oh, what am I gonna tell Eris though? Oh. That is not good. That blew up. So yeah, last time the creeper blew up, I sort of cleaned it up, but then Eris ended up fixing it, so I'm gonna just let that happen again. Oh, he blew up one of the bookshelves too. But yeah, thank you, Eris, for cleaning this up again. Wait, where did he even spawn though? Because like this place is relatively lit up. Oh, right here. That's where he spawned a bit. Okay, anyways, sorry, getting distracted here by the creeper. But up here is Sammy's house. So right over here, see Sammy's house, special thanks to a 12 keep out. We're just gonna replace this with keep. No, wait, we gotta go down a line. Keep that, nope, I can spell. Keep in. This makes no sense, but let's see if she notices. She just has her chest over here, you know, bed, furnaces, and in here is her Sammy's not so secret room and Sammy's little helper. So yeah, she also has a secondary entrance and some secret chests somewhere in the room that I don't know about, although I do know about. There's a little ladder that leads to the roof that's actually pretty cool. And then she has a secondary door that actually leads down to the farms. So, yeah, I don't know why she has that door, honestly. But if we just leave here, that was Eris's house and Sammy's house. So next off, I'm actually going to be showing you guys Jojo's house. Now that is, he's one of the members that I haven't really talked to. We just actually started talking recently. He seems really nice person, but his house is this way, and guys, I won't be doing that much of a cut. I'm just gonna be speeding up the footage just because that way you guys can get a sense of where everyone is. So I will see you guys when I get there. So we've made it to Jojo's house. He actually isn't too far from Eris's. If you can see the silhouette of that mountain over there, that is Eris's mountain. So we actually built right behind him, and oh gosh, this bridge is very, very scary. I actually don't know what he's working on. Oh, I totally would have fallen to my death right there. Oh my god. But it looks like he's working on something like a glass house or something like that. With one of them is missing. That is very dangerous, Jojo. Someone could have gotten hurt. Namely me. But I'm just gonna build steps up here because I have no way of getting back up. But yeah, this is his little house. He built this little platform over here. I don't know if it's really a house, more so just a base. I am taking so many risks right now. Oh my goodness. If I die on camera, guys, you know why. But if we go down here, this is actually the second part of his house. Let's go water bucket. Why did I still take damage? But he has his little house, nice potato farm, some stuff. Wait, why am I going through his chest? Let's not do that. As well as, I believe this is a strip mine. I don't really want to go all the way down there, but if I had to guess, I'd say it's a strip mine. So yeah, this is Jojo's base. Pretty cool. I definitely like his idea. Which, you know, seafront property, he has a downstairs and a very, very upstairs. So I'm thinking I watched one of his live streams. It seems like he's a fan of a water elevator, so that could be something that he does. I'm not sure. Maybe we'll have to see. But yeah, go check out his channel. You know, you can go see what he does. He does a lot of live streams, so he's definitely a lot more interactive. That's something that I like about him that's different from everyone else in the S&P. So, you know, you'll be able to talk to him in the live stream. So definitely go check him out, show him some love, and yeah. Anyways, I don't know where I am, but I'm just going to go speed up, and I will see you guys at the next house, which will be Jax. So yeah, that is going to be fun. Alrighty guys, so we are back at Jack's house. Now, if you guys recall from last, not last time, but a prior episode, I'm actually just gonna kill this creeper real quick. Don't want that blowing up like it did in Eris's house. But, yeah, anyways, so if you guys remember, Jack had this temporary base that I explained, you know, some farms, things like that, and I think his original plan was actually to build into this cave down over here, but, he actually changed his original plan to go this way. And also, guys, one thing that I was talking about that I said I was going to point out earlier, you might have seen some screenshots earlier this episode, hopefully I remember to put them, about the cave I explored and how massive it was. This is how massive it is. So Jack's house is a cave, right? Why am I getting lag spikes? Okay, there we go, it cleared. But Jack's house is a cave, right? And it has natural caves. Well, the cave also goes down into here. These caves connect that away near my house in the spruce biome. That is how large this cave is. That is easily 500, no, not even 500, probably close to 1,000 blocks. It is ridiculous. I went mining and they connect and I was mind blown. It is just so ridiculous how much the cave system is because, you know, Jack was exploring. I explored these caves. It was the first cave I explored. Jack is blowing up the cave and I looked around more. We probably explored maybe an eighth of it. It is just absolutely ridiculous. But yeah, I'm extremely hyped to go explore that later on. But yeah, anyways, getting off topic, but here is Jack's house. So he has the cool little slime launcher. And so here was the little glitch that happened. So I was running up and I decided to jump up. And for some reason, the slime blocker threw me into this wall over here and I suffocated to death. I don't know why it put me in this wall, but all my stuff was right here and I was dead. So yeah, that's how I ended up dying. But anyways, this is Jack's house, and I mean, I don't really like to play favorites, but I mean, honestly, this house is just absolutely amazing. He's done the most work out of all of us in the realms, and it's just absolutely ridiculous how much effort he's put into this. So he has his chest room down over there. I'm pretty sure majority of you have seen this already, considering you probably came from his channel, because, yeah, I'm pretty sure if majority of you are subscribed to me, you're subscribed to Jack as well, and if you guys aren't, then what are you doing? Come on, man. But he has his melon and pumpkin farm over here. Then over here, he has, I don't know why he has iron bars, but there is a little little hole over here where he can go do, what was it? That's his little jumper thingy. Actually, we're just going to go kill this villager zombie real quick. Die. Because there's his little dog scout, I believe it was, yes. And then actually down here, I believe, is a continuation of the cave. Yes. And the mob grinder that he blew up. Oh my goodness, I remember that. So yeah, this is Jack's house. So this is actually very, very cool. And oh, what is this? Oh, he added another room. So he has an enchanting room. So that is actually pretty cool. And yeah, I just really like what he's done with the cave and how he's like made it his... I missed that jump. I am terrible at this game. But yeah, I really like how he's, you know, just kind of edited the cave, put grass, made it seem more natural, less like a cave. And oh, here's his nether portal. But I mean, this is just, it's amazing what he's done with the place. Like, I honestly really, really like it. And so next off, we are going to be going to Echo Soldier's house. So yeah, I will see you guys there. So we're over here at Echo's house. Jack's house actually isn't too far away. So he has this nice little farm of cows and yeah, basically just cows. And then down here he has his actual farm of, you know, crops like wheat, melons, things like that. And then in here he has his humble little home. He's sort of been bigging out a cave. I think he's gonna have a cave house. I'm not too sure right now. But right now he just has a wing that's probably going to go this way, another one that's probably going to go this way. I'm not sure if it's going to go further than that because he does have his chest room. And then directly down here, I do believe this is just a strip mine. So yeah, that's his house. It's very, very comfy cozy. I really like it, honestly. And the design looks pretty nice. I like what he's done with the pillars with the cobble, not the cobblestone, the stone brick. So it looks really nice and it's really smooth. So yeah, that was Echo's house. Now, to get to Rage's and Fusion's house, I'm actually going to take the nether portal just to kind of show off the nether hub that was built. And also because it is extremely far away, if you were to cross this river, and then, why is there another arc over there? Weird. But if you were to cross this river and then run through this entire forest, actually, then you'd reach Rage's house. So, yeah, Rage is extremely far away from the rest of us, so I don't know why he built so far away, honestly. Because Fusion's relatively near spawn, and so am I, and then Rage is just kind of far away. So, yeah, we're going to catch another portal. I forgot to mention, down here is the zombie spawner. So, yeah, that's the zombie spawner that I worked on. Jack actually helped me out with the switch, so that was really, really nice of him, and we are getting lag spikes. That's weird. I hope it's not because zombies are spawning. I don't think it is. I don't think I'm within range of the spawner. But anyways, if we just go down here, we're just going to hop into the nether portal really quickly. And I think we're going to go to Rage's house, just so I can illustrate how far away it is. So, yeah, we're in the nether hub right now. And I do believe Rage's house is this way, if I'm not mistaken. This should lead me. That was Jack's little hub. And something that I'm actually going to be working on in the future, most likely, is that I'm going to be connecting everyone's house with rails. So, you know, you can just either, I'm not too sure if I'm going to do this in the nether or the overworld, in a sense that, you know, you can just pop into the nether portal and then, you know, take a train to their house. Or what we can do is that you just, you know, hop into the nether portal and then, or don't hop into the nether portal, just hop onto the minecart and go to their house. So, which one do you guys think would be better, you know, going via nether or overworld? Because the nether is a lot shorter because here we are at Rage's house. So as of now, everyone does have their own nether portal except for Jojo, Echo, and myself. I will be getting one once I finish up building my house, which I have not done yet. I do apologize. But yeah, here we are in Rage's base. I think I have to traverse through here. Yes, I do. But yeah, this is Rage's base. And actually, if we go... No, it's not down here. It's right over here. He has some stuff going down here. He has all his chests. He has a nice little trash can, actually. And Rage's house is actually very Asian-themed. So that's how he explained it, and I do believe part of it burned down. See, his roof kind of burnt down. I don't know what's happening. Something is honestly happening on the realm right now. So yeah, and then he has his nice little fishing hut over here. You know, you can just relax, go fishing. Oh, that's right. That's something I lost when I died. That's the only thing that did not respawn. I got everything else except for my fishing rod. So yeah, that was extremely frustrating because now I don't have a fishing rod anymore. But I mean, hey. We'll live, it's just a fishing rod. But if I do go this way, I believe. Yes, Rage has a spawner of his own. I'm not going to show you guys it just because, you know, it should be relatively self-explanatory. But Rage actually has a spawner that direction. And it is a skeleton spawner, so that is actually really nice. I've been using it a lot, if you noticed, in that ore chest that I had. We had like two rows of just bones and arrows. That is because I was farming at Rage's skeleton farm, right over there where that cobblestone pillar is. And actually, that is where I went mining last episode with Fusion, Eris, and Rage. So, in there was where we found the spider dungeon as well. So, Rage has two spawners right next to his house. So, you know, he's really, really lucky. And so, hopefully, he turns that into a, you know, another little farm thingy. There's two creepers and two skeletons. I'm out. So, you know, hopefully he turns that into another farm. That would be pretty nice. And yeah, we could have a spider and a skeleton farm. But anyways, we're just going to run over to Fusion's house, and I will see you guys there. And we are back, guys, with the final house. I'm just going to run past these zombies because I don't really want to bother them. But here we have Fusion's house, guys. So I'm actually not going to show you guys my new house in this episode just because I want to save it for off-camera work, some more of that, as well as I want to surprise you guys next episode. So, or maybe a future episode. I'm not too sure which episode I'm going to be showing it in, but this is going to be the last stop for today's episode. It has been a fairly long episode, But here we have Fusion's house. So if we go up here, he has a mountain house, sort of similar to Eris's, in a sense. And he has, oh, that is actually pretty cool. He has a little map. He has his bedroom, and then you go over here. I like what he's done with the glass, although I think this isn't supposed to be missing. In here, he has his nether portal, some farms. There's nothing back there, I believe. And then actually, if we go this way, we have his chest room and enchanting. And then upstairs is another farm, I believe. I think he had his melon farm up here. I'm not too certain because I helped him set up. Yep, he has his melon farm. So, yeah. Oh, that's a skeleton. I'm getting ambushed here. Die. Okay, there we go. And that is actually a brand new addition. I don't know what that is. I don't remember him building that. So let's go check it out. It looks like a pretty cool bridge. I think it's just a bridge leading to the other island. Yeah, that's what it is. But I mean, this is a pretty cool bridge. I mean, props to the Fusion for building it. So yeah, this is actually definitely really, really useful. Maybe he's gonna expand his house this way because he has a crafting table here. So if he expands his house and like build it on top of here, that would actually be really, really cool if that's what his idea is. But yeah, that's basically all for today's episode. We toured everyone's house, but I do have a question for those of you guys who have stayed this long, and props to you if you have, you are a true subscriber. But my whole question to you guys is, what do you want me to do next episode? So I should have, if I manage to set it up, a YouTube poll thing. It should be in the top right-hand corner, a little like eye with a circle around it. Deciding what should I do for episode 6, the options are, should I do work on my house or go to the Nether? So if I go to the Nether, I'll be just mining, things like that, probably killing zombie pigmen and dying a lot. It'll be fun, but we probably won't get much done. The other option is that I work on my house. You know, I'm going to finish up the raw part of the house, just the actual house itself, off camera. But then when we get back, I can maybe build a farmhouse, or I can work on the rooms, etc., things like that. So it's completely up to you guys. Hopefully the YouTube poll works and I learn how to set it up. But if it doesn't, then there will be a straw poll in the description. Just look for either one. They'll be there. And vote. And I thank you guys a lot. So anyways, as always, if you guys did enjoy, definitely make sure to drop a like down below. Once again, only if you guys did enjoy. And if you guys are a new subscriber to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And yeah, also guys, thank you for so much, so much for 7.5k subscribers. I mean, this has honestly been amazing. And yeah, I'll see you guys next episode. Peace out.